Creek on Channel 15 and in Waterton on Channel 4. We hope you enjoy your time with us today on CBC 9.
Hot and live to the only province in Canada that starts with the letter A, it's Switchback. Now, here they are, Keith and Ian.
Check it out. The guy doesn't even come dressed. Ian, I'm disappointed in you.
There's a story behind this missing shoe. The Switchback Time Machine, remember?
I heard about the Switchback Time Machine, Ian, but I'm worried about your shoe. I don't know.
What do you guys think? One shoe on, one shoe off? I just find that disorganized. Right? Disorganized?
Work.
Yeah?
Work.
Yeah!
You'll find out.
Disorganized, we're going to have ourselves one good show today. Because on today's show, Ian, of course, is going to explain to us how he lost that shoe, and I don't know how you lost it.
I lost it up at Fort Edmonton, and you're going to have to wait to find out about that. We talked to Dan Parish and Greg Vavra, and we have a Save Our Stamps video.
Saving stamps? Collecting stamps?
No, Stampeders Football Club.
Silly me. Sorry, it's, you know, the Edmonton blood in me. I only think of one football team, the Edmonton Eskimos, but of course, Stampeders need a lot of mention.
And
we're going to help them out.
They're getting help, too.
You bet. Batman's going to come down and try to help the Stamps out. And Stump the Artist, I think I'm going to take over again. Ian, your buzz buzzard was just too wild.
I doubt it.
Wild, wild stuff. We've, again, got a student guest that's going to come down and tell us all about Czechoslovakia. Mm-hmm. And the word contest. Television is the word. You take the word, split it up as many times as you can, make as many words.
Well put. We've got the Lanny McDonald hockey stick contest. And our rock videos today coming up are from Bruce Springsteen.
Hey, Bruce Springsteen, let a noise, a lot of noise. Let's hear it for Bruce. Oh, the bar.
We got a steer rider down here today, Travis Eklund.
Is he going to ride around on Edwina?
He's going to ride around on you.
I think Edwina would make a real good steer.
Tell the folks what the first video is.
First video is by Canada's own Platinum Blonde, and the situation, critical.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, I like it.
Good
I think
video.
The Platinum Blonde is a pretty popular video with this group.
Canadian group?
Well, really, they're going right to the top. Similar to Switchback with Keith and Ian.
Is it true you were practicing your card tricks last week?
You heard. Yes, it is.
Didn't know I was going to ask you right away, did you?
No, you didn't. You want me to go and do my card trick?
I put on my card shark hat.
Card shark hat, okay. All right? You ready?
You guys aren't going to believe this.
Okay, watch. Is everybody? Maybe we should go out and get somebody from the audience rather than... They might think it's fixed. Okay, we're going to go out and pick someone right from the audience, right in the front row. Okay, can we get a, you help us out. Okay, you together. All right, ready? Okay, you stick your finger in any way you like and stop the deck. Okay, you take that card out, take it out, show it to your partner, show it to the camera, don't let me see. Show it to the camera. Okay, put it back in. All right, you ready? You guys are ready? Watch this. Now I want you to stop it on the exact same spot. Ready, put your finger in any way you like, go, oh, there it is, take it out. Is that it? Yes, that's it. Again, he does it. A big round of applause. Let me just show you that the trick is not fixed. It's not wrecked. It's not fixed. Observe the deck. Every card is different. Of course, every card is different. Unless you go this way. Whoops. There. Then every card's the same. See? Cheat trick. Is that okay? Can we show a magic show later? What do you guys think? Yeah? No, yes, no. Mixed feelings, moving right along. Of course, on the rest of the show, we've got an awful lot more excitement. We've got Greg Vavra coming down from the... Okay,
He tells how it's done. He didn't have to do that.
Oh, you didn't have to do that?
No, he just showed
they still don't know
show
how it's
the
done.
Trick. Okay, birthdays. Catherine Silverson of Calgary celebrated her birthday last Sunday, and we forgot to mention it. Happy belated birthday.
It's a little late for last week, but guaranteed it's the first birthday wish you get for next year. You know, we like to be first. Here on Switchback, we're always first.
Number one. Birthday. Kevin Halls of Edmonton called in. He would like to wish his old buddy Kevin Briggs a happy birthday today, February 2nd. Kevin Briggs now lives in Calgary. Happy birthday, Kevin.
All right. Big round of applause for Kevin Briggs, who's made the big move to Calgary. I bet he's still an Oilers fan, though. See that game last night?
Jesus. Yeah, did you notice that the Flames are now playing on par with the Oilers? As a matter of fact, the Oilers lost a 4-0 lead to Calgary.
No, what it was is they're feeling awfully sorry.
No.
The Flames, they said, listen, Flames, we've got to try to boost the ratings, let you guys come at least close.
I think the Flames are playing excellent hockey. And I think that from here on out, the season's just going to go uphill for the Flames, and the Oilers are going to have a hard time holding on.
Let's take some phone calls and find out. Should we take a few phone calls?
Hit it.
Okay. All right.
All ready?
Ready.
Okay. Good morning, you're on Switchback. Hello? Hi, you're on Switchback.
Yeah?
Hi.
Hi.
What do you think about the way the Flames and the Oilers played last night?
Well, I think that the Oilers rule.
Hey, big round of applause for the yes, Oilers rule. Yeah. Just a second here. Why do you think the Oilers rule?
Well, I don't know.
Because she's intelligent?
I don't know. I just say...
They've got the Stanley Cup. They've won the best prize in the whole place. They've proven that they rule.
What do you like about the Oilers most? High-sticking, the way the coach shouts at all the players from the bench, the rough hockey.
If I was you, I wouldn't tolerate that abuse that Ian's giving you. So what we're going to do is we're going to go and find out what abuse was thrown on Ian when he visited Fort Edmonton Park. Mm-hmm. Let's go.
It worked. Edmonton, 1846, Fort Edmonton. But where's the guide? Where's Tim? Tim!
Ian, over here.
Oh, I made it.
Welcome to Fort Edmonton.
Thanks, Tim.
Come on in.
This place is huge, Tim. Why such a big gate?
This is the Indian Gate. This is where the Indians come when they bring their furs to trade.
Uh-huh.
Bringing beaver, otter, that sort of thing. They have them counted back there. And then, well, they trade them.
And what was this building before?
This is the trade store where the exchange is done. There'll be about 20,000 pounds of fur traded there this winter. And then they'll be packed in bundles in that machine over there. Then we'll take them down the river to Hudson's Bay.
Down the river? How do you get them down the river?
By boat.
Where do you get the boat?
We build them here. Come on, I'll show you.
In the middle of the prairie to build boats?
Yeah, 10 a year.
Oh, let's take a look.
So you actually make boats this size right here at the fort?
That's right. That's called a York boat.
Well, how would you get the materials to build a boat this size?
Well, the wood comes from locally, of course, but copper comes from England. There are 2,000 copper rivets in that boat.
How long would it take to make a boat like this?
Well, all winter.
And where would the supplies be carried to?
The York factory on Hudson's Bay. 4 tons of fur would go on this boat down to the bay.
How much water would you need for a boat like this, Tim?
Draws 14 inches when it's fully loaded.
And that's all?
That's all.
How many men?
10 men.
Well, where would they live around here?
Come on, I'll show you.
What are these buildings here for, Tim?
This is the married men's quarters.
How many people would live at the fort?
There's about 130 this year.
That many, there must be a lot of children.
Well, 20 or 30. Can't you keep count.
Do they go to school here?
No school here.
Where would they go?
Well, the chief factor will probably send his children to Red River to be schooled there. And there's some missionaries setting up, Lac St. Anne. Maybe some kids will go there, but most of them.
Gee, if the time machine was a little bit bigger, I think a bunch of the gang on Switchback might come down here.
This is the bachelor's house. This is where you'll be staying tonight.
What goes on in there?
Well, that's where the single men live. The clerks are from England and Scotland.
Oh, lots of card games.
I imagine so.
What about back here?
Well, that's the meat house. That's where they make the pemmican. Have you ever had pemmican?
No, but I got a feeling I'm going to.
You bet. It's a treat tonight.
What would this be here, Tim? Is this your hotel?
Hotel?
Oh, it's okay. You haven't come across those yet.
Well, this is the factor's house. Not in charge of the fort.
He's a matter of factor. What's a factor?
Well, he's the one who runs the district for the Hudson's Bay Company.
And his family lives in this house?
That's right.
Why so big?
Well, he wanted to live in a grand style. The rest of the fort call it the Folly.
Say, is he home right now?
No, but he wouldn't mind if we went in.
Let's go right to the bathroom. So what would a normal day in the fort be like for you, Tim?
Well, lots of different things to do. Some of the men are out at the fishing station bringing in the fish. Some are out hunting. Some are out taking care of the horses that we've got posted outside the fort. There'll be some working on the furs, some keeping the books. All kinds of different things to do.
Would they keep busy
Every day of the week? Every day of the week. There'd be some time on Sundays for writing letters, reading books, that sort of thing. But if there was work to be done on Sunday, it'd be done as well.
Well, it seems awfully quiet around here today. Is everyone out of the fort?
Everyone's gone working, except, of course, the CBC crew.
The CBC crew? What's that?
Don't worry, you'll find out.
Well, listen, Tim, I really enjoyed the tour, but I'm going to dematerialize if I don't get going here.
Dematerialize?
Don't worry. You'll find out. So long, Tim.
Adidas.
So that's what happened to your shoe.
Yeah.
Gonzo City.
The old switchback time machine.
I'm feeling faint just with the aroma of that foot. It's exposed and it's tough.
There's no one here would ever believe a word of that.
I don't know. I don't know. You guys in the front row are starting, their eyes are watering.
But the problem is I had to leave the darn shoe behind.
You had to leave your shoe behind?
Yeah.
That's an unfortunate thing. Listen, coming up, speaking about coming up, we've got Dan Parish coming down to explain about the rock video Save Our Step.
That's right, SOS. And also a young steer rider's coming up. And more rock videos are coming up.
Whoa.
My shoe!
Oh, goodness. Am I ever glad that's arrived. How to wear it? Crazy Bob? Hello? Hello?
I don't trust the time machine anymore.
I'm just glad it came. A plastic bag for both feet would be better. You guys stick around. We're coming back right after this. Put that shoe up.
You can say an orange is sweet and juicy and fun to eat. But there's one word that says all of that and a lot more. Sun-kissed. You have our word on it.
Coming back, I don't know. We've got two chairs here. Does that indicate that I'm supposed to go someplace? Or actually,
no, we can all stand right here. I'd like to welcome Dan Parish to the show. Dan, thanks for coming down. Now, a little background on Dan. He is a producer, and he made the video, the SOS video, for Save the Stamps. Right?
I've seen it.
It looks hot.
That's great. It was lots of fun to do.
Working with football players, is it hard to get them to, you know, be singers in addition to being football players?
Well, they were a little shy at first, but then they really got into it. They were having fun and, you know, dancing and singing out in McMahon Stadium. They were having a real hoot.
Just like they do at the football games.
I was curious about training Ralph the dog. Now, was that a difficult part of the whole video, getting Ralph to come out there and participate properly?
Well, it took a while. Every so often, we'd have to throw him a bone, and then he'd dance a bit, and throw him another bone, and he'd dance a bit, and throw another bone, and dance. And once you give him a couple of bones, away he goes. No problems.
No bones about the whole video at all?
No, nothing at all.
Well, listen, you're a producer, Dan. You operate on the principle like Crazy Bob does with just fear and intimidation.
Oh, you bet. Boy, I'll tell you, you don't look me straight in the eye, otherwise you melt. That's it.
Even with football players?
Well, they don't quite melt, you know. You call them sir.
With a CFAC?
Yes.
Sit down here, Dan. Go ahead. Sit down.
Thank you.
Please. Can we get you a soft drink, soda pop, coffee?
No.
Slow down. Easy. Listen, really. No, I'm kind of thinking maybe we could.
By the way, my car is outside. If you could wash it, please.
No problem. I'll have it done right after the show.
Very good.
No
thank
problems
you.
At all. We're kind of curious. Crazy Bob is our producer, and like he's just, to put it in a nutshell, mean. You know, he's mean. He expects a lot out of you. He wants us to work. You guys have heard of Crazy Bob, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. One bad news kind of guy, right? Yeah. We think Dan is probably a lot nicer, right?
Yeah.
So you probably have thinking about another show with a couple of big stars, maybe a cop show, detective
maybe.
Show.
Switchback Vice?
Rock video show?
No.
No? Okay, well, listen, get one
okay, back.
Okay, back
to the video.
Real quick, let's get back to the video. How long did it actually take to put that video together?
It took us 8 hours on Friday to shoot it, and then another 9 hours on Saturday to edit the whole thing together, and then 2 hours the night before to write the whole thing and put it all together.
Is that unusually fast for a video like that?
Yeah, it is. It's very fast. Usually you could have up to 3 or 4 months to do a video, but in our instance, because it came up so quickly and it was such a time based thing that it really had to get on the air real quick to make it good, that we did it in that time factor. But it
plus the weather.
Plus
you
the weather.
You didn't hurry. That weather would have been gone.
Oh yeah, we were lucky. The weather was with us. We had a lot of talented people working on it, which made it, you know, go real smooth.
How did you come up with the Billy Ocean idea, the Billy Ocean song?
Well, now that was written by people at CKXL, and the singer Martin Cochran sang the whole song.
Is he a Calgarian?
Yes, he is a Calgarian.
Did a great job.
It was great. I mean, a lot of people think it was Billy Ocean doing the song.
Sounds just like him.
Yeah, and with words and music like that, you really can't go wrong making a video. You really can't.
Let's take a look at it, shall we?
Oh, sure, love
All
to.
All right, roll our Crazy Bob. Going gets tough. I'm feeling like reaching into my pocket and getting out some money right off the bat.
Hey, listen, we just found out that that Marty Cochran that sang that is one of the fellows that works sometimes here on Switchback. One of the crew.
I've been giving him some singing lessons myself. Me.
Keith got near him. He couldn't carry a tune in a wash tub.
But I had two handles, I keep on dropping it.
Yeah.
That's okay. A terrific job, though. It's really, the medium that you've chosen, the way that it's going to work, is definitely right on the money.
Well, it's really helping the whole Save Our Stamps feeling, because it's getting people out, and it's showing them that they're not only football players, but they have fun.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's what it is. You know, it's not so much the financial support, I think, that they're interested in. You know, of course, they need some financial, but also the fact that we've got a whole city here that's right behind them. And also, isn't there, I was down at Flipside judging a lip-sync contest on Friday, and I was informed that they've got a special for students that they can get for $20. They get a season's pass that gives them a seat in the end zone.
So, and it's a great deal, because it's fun to go out there and support your team, and they're out there doing a good job, and every so often they may not win, but they're out there trying, and that's the main thing.
Exactly. Dan, what were some of the faces we saw in that video? There were some old football stars there, wasn't there?
Oh, yeah. You had a fellow way back from, I think it's 48, Woody Strode, super fellow. John Helton, who's a Shenley Award winner. Herm Harrison. And then, of course, you have the newer, the Greg Vavra, of course, who's been the lead singing on it. And the rest of the team.
So I remember back in the old days, old Herm Ham Hands Harrison, you know, and those cold fall nights and sitting up there watching the football games. It'd be a shame to lose that.
We won't lose it. There's no way. We're not going to let the Stamps go down.
No.
We're just scaring them a little bit. You know, we like to scare the players, the team.
The thing is, all sports teams have slumps. You know, the Flames went through the 11-game slump there, and usually the fans drop off in the slump. Comes along, and then when the slump goes, the fans build up again.
But you've got to support them.
Exactly.
Win or lose, you've got to support them, because they're out there trying, and they're doing it for you. You know?
Exactly.
What can some of our viewers do to help the Stamps?
Well, let's see. You really can go down and get season tickets. That's the best thing that you can do at this point. And just support them in every way. You know, give them, if you can't support them by buying season tickets, at least support them with your attitude and your want to stay in Calgary.
Yeah, I believe they've sold about 12,000 season tickets.
Even
that's right.
Now.
They're about halfway now. They're almost halfway.
That's super. Well, listen, we could sit around and talk about the Stamps, but we've got a couple of Cape Crusaders in the background.
Plus, you have my car to clean afterwards.
I've got your
and
car
my
to
shoes.
Clean.
You'll do my shoes afterwards.
Of course, we'll do the show. Okay. Of course.
Why don't you do this? Dan, you go for it.
Okay, let's go to Batman, the Great Train Robbery, Part 1.
Gotham City Central Park. And truth and justice will win out.
Dan Parish already has the host for his next upcoming show. You don't need to do this.
What do you mean he's got
his host? It's too late.
He told me I could, if I already washed his car. He told me if I could look good and dressed up nice and neat and tidy that I'd have a job at
cleaning the one headlight.
Worldwide show?
That's not washing the car.
That was the whole car I cleaned at. Listen, we could argue about this all day. Listen, we can't argue about this
coming
all
up
day.
On the show, we've got a rodeo rider, more rock videos, and Edwina live right after this.
You mean no good with the tie anyway?
Not gonna work.
Not gonna work?
Not gonna work.
Is perhaps the greatest discovery of the 25th century. A dwelling called the Split Level Ranch. Marvelous.
What's this, Professor?
Ah, a spherical object. They used to hurl at each other with great velocity.
Professor, what's this? What is it?
I have no idea. Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Time for the Stump the Artist portion of our show.
No show, no go. If they're not going to put me as the new host of the worldwide show, I'm going back to Hollywood. Hollywood. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba, Hollywood. Tell the whole world who you are there, Cupcake.
Robin.
And you live in Calgary? Do you know how Stump the Artist works?
Used to.
You used to. Well, you better remember real quick, because we're on the air.
Live.
It's time we brought in the official pen.
The music for the pen. Crazy? I call him crazy. Some call him Bob. Some call him Crazy Bob. I call him crazy. Oh! What a tune. Look at this. Oh, I like it.
Where's your pen?
Thank you, Al. Come on in a little closer, Al. I think that you've got to get in here. No one's getting a chance to look at this, man. Look at this tailored operation here, Al. But your button's undone there, Al.
I wanted to report that your partner here is trying to sabotage your pens.
Oh. Al, you weren't supposed to tell him about it.
Trying to break into the vault where we keep these special pens, and he's...
He's trying to do it.
I got caught.
What do we say about... Boo! Boo! Thank you, Al.
We'll keep a better look after them.
I think we're going to have to put an arm guard around there. I'm going to check him just to make sure he didn't get in there. That one looks pretty good, and this one, for a backup, looks pretty good.
He wanted to put him in cold storage.
Well, we'll put him in cold storage.
Along with Keith.
All right. Thanks, Al.
Thank you.
Okay, Robin, we've got the two pens here. Do you want the little one or the big one?
The little one.
The little one it is. Okay, little pen for a little gal. Go for it. Make your mark. On your mark, get set, go. Perfecto mundo. Thanks. Oh, Robin, you got to stay down
don't
here.
Don't run away, Robin.
We need your help still. She's trying to escape. She knows I'm going to win.
Well, seeing how the theme of the show today is Save the Stamps, I'm going to have to say football player.
Football player? Football player? Can anybody see a football player in that? Yeah? Yeah? I think I should get a little extra time because that's a real tough one. Yeah? Extra 30 seconds. Yeah, extra 30 seconds. Yeah, yeah. Okay, Robin, that's a very tough line. Okay, I'm ready.
On your mark?
I'm ready. Wait
Get
a minute.
Set.
Okay.
Don't go yet.
I'm not.
Think about it.
I'm thinking.
Go.
What do you think, Robin? We'll get Robin's opinion first. Speak into Mr. Microphone here, Robin. See, you did it, Keith. It looks excellent.
You did it. Looks excellent.
Perfect. I like her a lot. Robin, come back here. What do you think?
Come on up here, Robin.
Yeah, if I made it. No.
I think you've done your part to save the stamps, Keith.
I think so. Come on, Robin. You and I are going to co-host this show. I got to just put in the horses and you're kind of running this way and running this way.
Touch it up a bit.
And the little tail over there. Okay, there's the stampeder. Go, stamps, go.
So next year when you sit and watch football...
Go, Ian, go.
When you watch a football game next year, you can... feel proud that you did your part to save our stamps.
I think so. And now, Ian, the big job is now up to me. Robin, are you going to come over here and help us? You don't want to help us? Okay. Come on over here. Come on.
Here she comes.
Here she comes.
I'll trade you places.
A perfectly good trade. Okay. There you go, Robin. You sit right up here on that one. And I'll sit up here on this chair. Perfect. That's the way I like to sit when I'm talking to TV, too. We'll sit back. Actually, why don't we face the camera? Okay, Robin, and how old are you?
9.
9 years old? That's, what, a year older than Ian? Did you know that's a year older than Ian? You didn't know that? Is there anyone you'd like to say hello to?
Yes, there is. There's a whole bunch of people I'd like to say hello to, actually.
Okay, what we're going to do now is... Where is he? He's over there. Now, have you ever seen a more unusually dressed individual in your entire life?
No.
He is pretty crazy looking. Look at him. He looks like an Australian. Have you ever seen an Australian like that? We've got helpers that are out. They've come down to the station to show us all about their country. Now, are you going to tell everyone at home what the country is? Everyone at home, you're not supposed to hear me whisper in her ear, okay? She's from Czechoslovakia. Okay, now tell everyone. Quiet. Rat Finks, you're not supposed to hear that. Okay, I want, Robin, this is your big chance to be a television celebrity, and I think you're going to do a terrific job doing it. Now, are you ready? Look at Joe. Joe, come over here. I want you to show this expression. Poor Joe sitting here. He's going, I don't know. Where are we?
May I?
You can.
Excuse me.
Hey, there.
My pen fell.
Okay. Czechoslovakia, that's pretty close.
Here it comes,
are you ready? Here it comes, are we ready? There, okay, that's her name. Michelle Mista,
I mean...
You just move your lips and I'll do it. You go like this. Michelle
Mista from Czechoslovakia.
You try it again, say it one more time.
Mista, Czechoslovakia.
Perfect. Worked for me. Bye, Robin.
Hello. My name is Michelle. I'm 10 years old, and I came to Canada with my parents and my brother 3.5 years ago. I was born in Czechoslovakia. This country is the heart of Europe, and it's 5 times smaller than the province Alberta. The country consists of 2 territories, Bohemia and Moravia, is 1 territory. The other territory is the Slovak. There are 2 Slovaki people, the Czechs and the Slovaks. Praha is the capital of Czechoslovakia. The nation food is Czech dumplings with roast pork and sauerkraut. On folklore festivals, special in Slovak, you can see different folklore customs. Typical for Czechoslovakia are dolls made from corn leaves. Well known in Canada, it is the crystal, also Czech beer, pilsner. In sport, it is the Czechoslovakia ice hockey team. From Czech music, you can know the song Beer Barrel Polka. Thank you for your attention. And if you would like to know more about Czechoslovakia, go and see the Czechoslovakia Builder in Vancouver Expo 86. Anini, Ke, Keith, and Ian, a switchback.
Do you want to know what a mosquito's favorite sport is? Skin diving. Speaking of that, here comes Mr. Keith.
I was under the water looking for the evasive turtles when I think I'll have to go back. Ian, tell them what is coming up.
Keith.
Au revoir.
Keith making waves at the waves pool. Let's take a look.
Water, waves, fun, sun, good times. I figured for sure Crazy Bob was sending me to Hawaii, but no such luck. He managed to find waves here in Calgary, where at the Southland Leisure Centre, and Al Golby, you've got to explain to us all, how do you guys make waves?
The waves, Keith, are created by wave generators located in the pool basement. They're run by 75 horsepower motors, and the air is directed into 3 separate chambers located at the end of the wave pool. The end wall in the wave pool is a suspended wall with the water going back behind the wall. And with these air generators, the air is forced into these air chambers and is pushed out by air. The water is pushed out by the air, and that's how the waves are created.
So you've actually got giant compressors underneath that are forcing the water out?
That's correct.
Okay. That's why you get that sort of swirling motion where it's...
That's correct. The end wall is divided into 3 chambers, and there's the sliders in the back, and they move out to the outside chambers, and then they move both into the inside chamber, so we get the movement of the water going back and forth.
Oh, I see. So you're pointing it all this way, and then you swish it back this way, and swish it back this
way? That's correct.
And they're giant wave makers.
That's correct.
What? No giant tide makers or giant fish makers?
Not that far yet. No.
Not that far yet. How many of these wave pools are actually in operation in Alberta?
We have 4 in the province of Alberta, 1 in Edmonton and 3 here in Calgary.
Edmonton's kind of gypped here. How come we only have 1 in Edmonton? Hmm?
Calgary's got to be ahead of Edmonton in something, Keith.
Yeah, true. We do have the Stanley Cup Oilers and a pretty successful team all the way around. How long has this wave pool been in operation here?
We opened up in June of 83.
So it's actually been down here for quite some time.
Almost 3 years, yes.
Wow. Now, the waves don't run continually. Is it all the time waves?
No. We are open to the public from 9 in the morning till 10 in the evening, 7 days a week, 12 till 8 on stat holidays. And the waves are operated 12 minutes on and 12 minutes off.
That's to give you a little bit of a rest to get your strength back.
It gives the public a rest from the waves, and it gives our mechanical equipment a rest as well.
In addition to the waves, I see a water slide and a great big giant net and a jacuzzi hot tub.
Correct.
This place is open. What were the hours again?
From 9 in the morning till 10 in the evening, seven days a week.
That's pretty well a 13-hour day. Now, if I could convince the entire Switchback crew that this is a place that I should be doing extensive research, I think they'd go for it.
Let's try it.
I think we should. Can I go into the water?
You sure can.
All right, I'm going to the water. We're going to see you guys a little later. Al, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Everybody surfing, how gonna live and see it? How gonna go surfing with me? I'm going surfing, cause ba-ba-do-ba. I tell you, this water is going to be something else. You're going in, aren't you, Dennis? Dennis?
Oh, you chicken, what's the matter? No nerve? No nerve? Come on! Come on! Come on!
That Crazy Bob always sends me to have the fun.
I'm trying to keep things organized. Crazy Bob's seen me doing the work, and he just realizes that I am probably turning into one of the keenest, sharpest working guys around.
How did Dennis go down that slide with the camera in his hand with all the water?
That, Ian, is probably the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
I can't tell you that, Ian.
Technical, ask a serious
technical,
question.
Technical information, Ian. I can't share this sort of stuff with you. I'm afraid that it's just impossible. Tell all the viewers that are at home exactly what that is you're holding, Ian.
If you want to win number 9's hockey stick used in an actual Calgary Flames game.
One of the winning games or losing games? I'm curious. I bet you the folks at home are wondering.
One of the Calgary Flame games. All you have to do is send in your name and your address to CBC. And we'll have the address up for you. And you can win this. There's no skill testing question, and it's a beautiful hockey stick. I wouldn't mind having it on my wall.
Send your letters and address them to happily to Box 1700, Station M, Calgary, T2P3Z7, Switchback. That way you're going to have a chance at winning this hockey stick if you really want a Lanny McDonald hockey stick. I don't know. There's the signature on it.
Autographed by Lanny
McDonald.
Can you
read this? Can you zoom right in on that? Can you read that? Yes. From Lanny to you. Something you could probably think of. Put over the mantelpiece?
Yes, it's a beautiful hockey.
Or put it under the mantel? Ah, stop the fires. I'm only kidding, of course. No, really. Lanny, that's terrific. We've got hockey sticks. We've got everything here.
And we've got the television, the word contest coming up. And we've got to tell folks about that. They've got to take the word television, the same as they did with the word switchback. Make it into as many different words as you possibly can. Now, I've had people tell me they've got over 100 words out of the word television already.
I can't even read 100 words, Ian. That last
I know.
One, holy Dinah. Boy, oh boy, oh boy, I'm telling you, that's a tough test. Tough test.
Right, all
we're
the words
giving
out?
It. Nothing is for nothing anymore. Switchback is now a game of skill, a program of intelligence, a program of high IQs, a program of just, it's difficult.
And speaking of skill, they win the game Balderdash.
Speaking of skill, they win the game Balderdash?
Yeah, the skill involved
in the
game.
Listen, you're going to have to explain that to me, Ian, but right now we're going to have to take a little break while Ian explains Balderdash to me.
Class is perhaps the greatest discovery of the 25th century. A dwelling called the Split Level Ranch. Marvelous.
What's this, Professor?
Ah, a spherical object. They used to hurl at each other with great velocity.
Professor, what's this? What is it?
idea.
Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Good morning, and welcome to another edition of City Lights with your host,
Hello.
Ian Linehan,
and
another
show.
Celebrity guest.
Today we are unable to have Corey Hart here as he's preparing for his upcoming tour from Montreal, but we do have him live via satellite. Corey, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, Ian.
Let's start off, Corey, by finding out, have you ever tripped on your bottom lip?
Have I ever? Oh, many times, especially when I'm on stage singing to all those people. It's hard, you know.
Mm-hmm. Let's start at the beginning, Corey. It was once said that when you were born, you were but a mere baby. Can you elaborate on that?
Well, I don't know if I've ever grown up, actually. I'm trying not to.
I read that your mother said that if you pout, your mouth would stay like that. It did. Thoughts on that?
Well, I figure that if I pout for the rest of my life, someone will throw me money someday.
Who put the eggs in your hair?
Actually, it's not eggs. It's just that I never wash my hair.
Mm-hmm. In 42 years, you'll be 65. Why?
Why do you ask me all these stupid and hard questions? I don't know how to answer these.
Just take a wild guess.
A wild guess? Ian, why do you do this to me?
Why Corey Hart? Why not Corey Lungs? Corey Stomach? How's about Corey Brain?
Well, actually, it comes from the heart, from me to my fans, and that's why I use the word heart.
Corey, in a serious vein here, Montreal, 1979, you, two other people, at a corner table, eating beans. What happened?
No one was supposed to know about this. How did that get out?
Oh, I do a little extra research and find these things out.
Yes, you're amazing. You really do your homework.
Yes, I certainly do. Excuse me.
Corey. Oh! Hey, Corey Hart, man.
Mr. Rock! How are you?
Hey, I'm just great.
You know Corey?
Oh, yeah, me and Corey, we go way back. We've been making a scene on the silver screen.
Totally
yeah,
impromptu. This wasn't planned. Would you two like to just rap?
Well, rap, tap, tap. I'm telling you, this is one radical cat. I just can't believe you're looking so fine. Just fine.
Well, Corey, thank you, Mr. Rock.
I'm doing great. I'm cleaning up, so to speak.
That's funny. Mr. Rock taught me everything I know.
Oh, you're way too kind, but that's absolutely true, absolutely. I couldn't have said true words. How's your ma? How's your pa? How's your family?
They're great, thanks. They're great.
Right on, back in Montreal, you, summertime girls, everything else going well?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I did grow up in the Bank of Montreal.
You bet. Yeah, I did. We met in the trailer lineup.
Corey, any questions you'd like to ask the janitor?
What do you do with that broom, Mr. Rock?
Well, I was playing it. I was trying to put a little gig together. Maybe I can show it to you. I'm on TV. I'm dropping my shades. Can you hold on to my shades there,
Certainly.
Ian? Can I play it to one of these cameras? Like, I got a couple of gigs. I'm sorry.
I think you better stick to the sweeping.
I'm more of a solo act. Solo, you shouldn't be able to hear. Maybe I better split. Listen, Corey, I got to roll. I got to stroll. I got to make like a bakery truck driver and haul buns, but I'll catch you later.
Well, nice
I appreciate
to see
that, bro.
Totally impromptu.
Oh, awesome. Totally awesome.
Corey, we're going to have to run along. We'd like to thank you very much for joining us, and good luck up on the upcoming tour.
Thank you, Ian. I'll keep pouting in the meantime.
Do that.
Okay, I'd like to welcome Travis Eklund to the show, who's a 14-year-old steer rider. Travis, how did you get started riding steers?
I went to a steer riding school and just started riding.
Were you scared?
Yeah.
The first time you get up on a steer must be similar to the first time a pilot gets into an airplane. You're all by yourself and you don't really know what's going to happen.
Yeah, that's true. About right.
Any injuries?
Yeah. Cloverdale, BC, and that's about all I can remember right now.
Cloverdale, BC, what happened?
Oh, my steer fell on top of me.
How badly hurt were you?
I was in the hospital overnight.
Well, your parents must freak right out watching you riding steers.
Yeah.
Did they try to deter you from doing it?
Mm-hmm, yeah. Dad's told me a couple times he wishes I didn't ride and stuff like that.
What do you tell him?
That's what I want to do for a living.
Now, after steer riding, do you go on to bull riding? Is that a natural progression?
Yeah.
Isn't it true that bull riding is the most dangerous of rodeo sports?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why do you want to do it?
I don't know. It's risking and it's fun.
It must be really, it must be a real rush when that gate opens and you come flying out into that pen, the arena. Yeah. Can you hear the people all yelling when you're up on a steer?
Not
or
really.
Does your mind just go blank and you just concentrate on what you're doing?
Just usually concentrating on the steer and not thinking about nothing else.
What do you hang on to when you're on a steer?
It's a rope. It's rope and it's got a handhold and it's got, you put a bell underneath it to pull the rope off and that.
Now, sometimes you see the rodeo cowboys get stuck on the animals. Their hands get trapped. How does that happen? Do you wrap your hand on really, really tight?
Oh, no, I ride two hands. The bull riders ride one hand. They use a death wrap. It's where they wrap over the hand and wrap behind and over again.
And
if they fall up the wrong side, they can't get out of it unless someone goes in and takes them out of it.
That's why they call it the death wrap.
Yeah.
Now, you participated in the Calgary Stampede. Was it 2 years ago?
Last year and 2 years ago.
And what happened?
Last year, I won the Calgary Stampede and never did much 2 years ago in the Calgary Stampede.
So you won the Calgary Stampede for your age group?
Yeah.
That must have been quite a thrill.
Yeah. Pretty well.
Now, you travel around to a lot of rodeos. How many would you go to in the summer, say?
45 to 50 a year.
How do you travel?
My mom and dad usually take me down the road to each rodeo.
Gee, that's a lot of driving.
Yeah.
Where are the rodeos? All in Western Canada?
All over Canada. All over Canada, BC and Saskatchewan.
Have you met any of the greats yet? Larry Mahon or anyone like that?
Johansson brothers.
Well, the Johansson brothers are bull riders, aren't they?
Yeah.
And they're from right by Calgary here, I think Strathmore?
Yeah, some of them live right in Calgary here.
And it can be fairly lucrative. I think one of the Johanssons won $50,000 at Stampede, didn't he?
Yeah, 2 years in a row.
2 years in a row?
Dale Johansson.
Okay, let's take some calls for Travis, good morning. You're on Switchback.
Hi.
Hi. What's your question for Travis?
I just wanted to know, how long have you been riding?
4 years now.
Do you know of Crazy Bob rides?
No.
No?
He's on Keith and Keith and myself. He's on our back a lot.
Well, that's all I wanted to say. And I wanted to say hi to my mom and my friend, Nicole.
Okay. Thanks for calling. Good morning. You're on Switchback.
Hi.
Hi. How are you today?
Pretty good.
What's your question?
How long has he been taking it, and what encouraged him to take it?
I don't know. What encouraged me?
Did you watch rodeo on TV before and think, gee, I'd like to try that?
No, I've been to a rodeo, and I just went to one and said, Dad, I want to do that.
And that was it?
And he goes, you find rodeo school and you can do it. I found a school, and at first he wasn't going to let me do it, but mother told him, if he said he finds a rodeo school, he can try it. So I went to rodeo school and started riding.
That's great you have supportive parents, because Gretzky wouldn't be where he was today if his parents weren't supportive either. Any other questions?
I just wanted to ask you if you could play some Corey Hart videos.
Yeah, we sure will. We'll get those on for you.
Thanks.
Thanks for calling. Good morning. You're on Switchback.
Hi.
Hi, what's your question for Travis?
How did you get involved with steer riding?
I don't know.
Why did you pick steer riding over, say, bucking horses or roping?
I don't know, it was the only event I could do in rodeo under my age group.
So do you hope to expand after into other areas of rodeo?
Yeah.
Okay, any other questions for Travis?
Can I request a Velcro fly by ZZ Top.
Okay, you just did. Thanks for calling. They're gonzo. Sorry. Okay, we've got a short picture, a film made of Travis. Let's take a look at it.
Okay, now this is a silent picture. Here you are coming out of the chute.
Yeah.
Wow, that's quite a ride.
This is the one from Calgary Stampede.
Now, what's the most dangerous thing here, though? If you fall off, I guess you really got to watch those hoofs, don't you?
Yeah. You got to get out of the way as fast as you can and head for the fence, because they will chase you.
They will?
Yeah, they will chase you. Yeah. They will chase you. I've had them chase me before.
Do they have horns on them, like sharp
Some
horns?
Some do, yeah.
Do they ever put balls on the end of the horns or blunt them?
No.
Can we take another look at that? That was so quick. I think we better take a look at that again. Have a look at Travis bopping and bucking. Is it coming?
No.
Oh, we're not going to watch it again. Well, Keith, you're over there smiling. Any questions from the audience?
Well, I certainly do. I'm just riding a wild chair, wrestler. Travis, you're right. Oh, you're mind. You're crazy. But mind you, to win first place at the greatest outdoor show on earth and having it your hometown is pretty darn admirable. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think you went in for the girls. What do you think? Do you like cowboys?
So-so.
So-so. Oh, well, let's find ourselves. Who likes cowboys? You like cowboys? You got any questions for Travis, the cowboy here?
How long, have you, I never heard how badly you got hurt, like.
What's the worst injury you've had, Travis?
That was a good way to
phrase. Cloverdale, B.C., where my stair fell on top of me and I was in the hospital. I was having convulsions and everything in the middle of the arena.
Wow. Wow.
That must have hurt.
I'll say. Did you get right back on a steer, like riding a bike, as soon as you fall off, get back on it right away? Is that the trick?
Yeah, you can do that, but some rodeos I couldn't. I ended up in the hospital overnight. They wouldn't let me ride the next rodeo the next day.
Youch. Okay, we've got another girl over here. Okay, this little buckaroo here. What question have you got for Travis?
How did he get interested in it?
Just went to rodeo and started riding. I mean, went to see a rodeo and went to steer riding school and started riding.
Now, at steer riding school, is it all practical? Do you have to just sit down and ride the steers right off the bat, or do they give you some books to read?
You start off practicing on a barrel, and then you go on to riding one steer, and then the next day you go on a couple more barrels for a little while, and then you possess on riding steers. Next day they'll go on with the barrel and then ride steers, and then they'd have like little finals for belt buckles. And they'd score you in that. And that's about all the steer riding school is about.
How many buckles do you have now?
Four.
Four buckles?
Yeah.
More buckles than we have. You got any questions for Travis?
How long were you in the hospital for when you were hurt?
One night.
One night in the hospital with a steer? What about the steer? How long was he in the hospital for?
I don't know.
You've got a question? Look, all the girls, Travis, every one of the girls. I've got one. Okay, go ahead.
What age did you start riding?
I started when I was 11.
We better, just to balance things out, what's your question for Travis?
How long are you going to continue?
As long as I can. It might end next year and it might go on for another 4 years.
I think you're going to knock them out. We're going back to you, Ian.
Thanks, Keith. Listen, when you go to those rodeos and you see the guys, the weathered old cowboys that have been doing rodeo for a long time, and I've been to some rodeos and I've seen those guys come in and they kind of limp in, and do you ever look at them and think, boy, I tell you, when I'm getting into bull riding, I'm going to be into some rough stuff.
Yeah.
So you're going to go for it anyway.
Yep. Looks like fun. Can't do really much. It's one in a million that get hurt.
Yeah.
Not very often.
Puts a little zip in life.
Yeah.
Well, thanks, Travis. Like, thank you for coming down, and good luck on your rodeo career.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. They like it. Okay, we're going to go and take a look at Batman Part 2, The Great Train Robbery.
Are you sure the phone isn't out of order, operator?
You might have realized that good, even though it's sometimes sidetracked. Always repeat. Always triumphs over evil.
Okay. There's all kinds of excitement, Ian. Tell them what's coming up.
We've got quarterback Greg Vavra and Edwina live right after this short break.
Thank you.
You can say an orange is sweet and juicy and fun to eat. But there's one word that says all of that and a lot more. Sun-kissed. You have our word on it.
It's time now for us to join the continuing story, Edwina's Mailbag. Now, here she is, that bovine beauty, Miss Edwina.
Oh, hello, everyone. Hello, it's I, Edwina Bovine, and I have a special guest here today with me on Edwina's Mailbag, Mr. Greg Vavra. Greg, it's so good of you to come here and see us here at Switchback. How are
you,
dear?
Well, it's good to be here, Edwina.
Let's have a big hand for Greg. Oh, I'll tell you, Greg, it's been quite the week for the cow. I've just met two celebrities, you, and earlier on in the week, I went to the Corey Hart concert. Oh, it was totally wicked and awesome. Did you go to the concert?
No, I wasn't able to make it to the concert. It sounds like it was exciting.
He is such a mega babe, I could die. You know, after the show, he wanted me to go out with him, Greg, but I said, Corey, I never surrender. Well, if that didn't just melt the gel in his hair. Well, dear, now, you're the quarterback of the Calgary Stampeders, is that right?
That's true.
Now, I'll be brutally honest with you, Greg. I don't know anything about football. Now, what does a quarterback do?
A quarterback is a fellow that calls the plays and hands the ball off to either two running backs or throws the ball to either of four receivers.
Mm-hmm. I see. Yes. Well, how long have you been tossing the old pigskin around, dear?
I've been playing football for about 9 years now.
Really? That's amazing. You know, I love football, but I can never tell where the puck is. Oh, call me silly. Now, I also understand that you were the lead singer in the Save Our Stamps video.
Yes, I was.
Yes, we played that earlier, dear. Now, I must say, you're quite the mover and shaker. Have you ever thought of a career on the stage?
Not yet, but if the football fortunes don't turn around, I may just do that.
Well, oh, speaking of which, dear, here, in my hoof, I've got a dollar here that I'd like you to take.
Just well,
take
thank you very
That's
much.
That's my contribution to saving our Stampeders.
We can use all the help we can get, Edwina. Thank you.
And believe me, believe me, dear, with the budget that Crazy Bob gives me for this show, that's a big amount of money.
Well, we appreciate it.
Well, yes, I just hope it's well spent, you know, yes.
It is, and it will be.
Now, I understand that you are also involved with hockey, that you play some exhibition games with the Stamps?
Actually, that's true. We have a hockey team, and we go around to various small towns in Alberta and play the communities. And our next game coming up, which will be of interest to some people, will be against the media next Sunday.
Oh, I hope we slaughter them.
February 9th, I believe. Mm-hmm. And it will be played at Max Bell Arena, and all the proceeds for that will go to ticket sales for the Stampeders as well.
Well, that's wonderful, Dan. And you're a coach for the Minor Hockey League, is it?
Yes, I do. I do some coaching in the Minor Hockey Association in Alberta, or in Calgary, with the Southwest Division of the Calgary Blues.
Well, you're one busy man.
It keeps me hopping.
You must keep yourself in peak physical form, right?
Well, it takes some time, but I do manage to stay in shape.
Well, maybe after the show we can go do a few bench squats or something. Come up
well,
to the
I'd
condo.
Like that.
Well, you know, I'm really glad you came because my friend Madeline and I had a date with the Stampeders last night, and they never showed up. There we were on the 50-yard line, our hopes and dreams dashed. Oh, I was so lonely out there. Madeline's a nice girl, but boring. Well, dear, it's been wonderful seeing you. It's been wonderful talking to you, and it's time now for another rock video. Would you like to introduce
me? It's been my pleasure, and right now we have Bruce Springsteen with a video.
He is the boss!
really, he had to take off. They're having breakfast brunch down at J.R. Houston's in Save Our Stamps. Come on down. Participate. Let's face it.
Boys, you know what time of year is coming up?
What?
Valentine's Day.
Yeah, I know.
I can feel a contest coming on.
Yes, a contest. Yeah, yeah. And we'd like people to send in some Valentine cards, but they've got to be homemade artistic endeavors. Now, for the people at home, it'll be easy to make cards for me because everyone loves me so much, and it'll be easy to make a Valentine's card.
Nothing to it, Edwina. I'd like to second that. I think you
but
could
But that counts.
What? And so they have to send their cards to Switchback, Box 1700, Station M, Calgary, T2P3Z7.
Well done, Edwina.
And the draw is on February 16th, isn't it, Keith?
It sure is.
And
February
16th. What's the prize, dear?
The prize can be the Sony Walkman.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, Crazy Bob is just, I don't know.
He's a very radical man.
He's awfully generous, I tell you. He's an awfully nice guy. I'm going to be sending in Valentine after Valentine. And that's all you've got to do. Send him in to Ian, Crazy Bob, Edwina the Cow, Joe the Floor Director.
Get your Valentine's into us because Valentine's Day isn't that far away.
Yes, no. Make sure you get the Valentine's to everyone else you want to get them to, too.
Yes.
Also, I'd like to say hi to Chris Prod and all his buddies watching Switchback, and also say thank you to Dan Parish and Greg Vavra for coming down here today.
Yes.
And to our own Marty Cochran, who was the singer on that video.
Let's have it for Marty.
Marty, yeah.
Woo!
Big Marty. Marty the Smarty.
Can that guy sing or what? I thought that sounded just like Billy Ocean. I really did.
I did.
A lot of people fooled on that. Mm-hmm. Michelle Mista, our student guest today, Fort Edmonton Park, putting up with me and the Southland Leisure Centre in Calgary for not drowning Keith totally.
I was very happy that they didn't drown me.
And also Travis Eklund. He's going to be a rodeo star, that guy.
He was riding my cousin star. In that video. Did you see that? That was my cousin he was riding.
Was that your cousin?
Yes.
Edwina, have you
always
ever done any steer riding? Have you ever had people ride on you?
Rodeo
it's
work?
An ugly story, and I'd rather not talk about it. I don't think we have time to get into it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a pretty hectic, pretty wild sport.
It is, but what a brave young man he is.
I should say
not for riding, but for coming on this show.
Really? Gee, it smells like a barnyard. Do you smell barnyard in here? Yeah? Yeah? Edwina, did you have time to...
Well, it's my new cologne, shower? Evening in Hobima.
Oh, Edwina. I don't know.
$3 a quart.
Squeeze that cow's nose. Listen.
Hey, is that a new hat, Edwina?
This is a rather nice new hat. Do you like it, dear?
I like the lilacs on there.
Yes.
I think we better make a special thanks to Ian Lineham that came down.
When do I get my interview with Ian Lineham?
He's too big, Edwina. He's big, he's busy, he's on the move. Stay tuned next week or the week after. There could be more Switchback Vice. Oh. The Switchback Vice is very nice. Or maybe a little bit of Miami advice. Or
good,
Edwina's advice. Or somebody's advice.
Milk it, dear, milk it. Squeeze your head in the vice.
Remember, SOS, save our stamps. Don't let them go down without a fight. Let's kick them
Have
right
an
up
awesome
to number one.
Week, everybody.
Number one. We're number one. We're number
Join
one.
Join us next week for
We're
Switchback.
Number one. We're number one. We're number one. Save our stamps. Let's do it.
This is Herbert W. Honeylungs, your sincere and tasteful Switchback announcer, inviting you to send your Valentines to Keith and Ian. And if you could, please send one to me. I'm so lonely.